quarantined for a year. It's not the kind of thing most new parents would volunteer for, but as KMBC 9's Bev Chapman reports, one local couple is doing just that to protect their children.
Stranger!
Watching them now, it's hard to believe that nothing was normal about the first 9 months of life for the Van Gotham twins.
I think we were given an 85% chance that they would survive.
Anna and Reed, due last July, were born at the end of March.
It was at 26 weeks, and we knew they weren't the youngest ones in the NICU, but they were close to the youngest, and they were really, really sick for a long time.
They remained in neonatal intensive care for most of the summer. Anna weighed 2 pounds 10 ounces, Reed 1 pound 10 ounces. Their parents say their heads were the size of limes.
There were so many days where we couldn't even touch him. You know, we'd go in and they'd say, "We can't, he's too fragile today for you to touch him."
Both dad and mom took shifts at the hospital, probing doctors and nurses for answers.
It was hard to hear "wait and see" when you're asking, "Is your child going to be able to breathe on his own?"
Finally, after weeks of loving their children at arm's length, the babies grew stronger.
They're hooked up to monitors for months in the NICU, and then all of a sudden they just hand you your baby and you walk out.
Go home, good luck.
But Kyle and Laura Van Gotham aren't relying on luck. That's why you'll find a note on their front door asking you to remove your shoes and hand sanitizer in the living room.
Let's go eat some bananas.
They know the baby's immune systems are still very fragile. That's why they decided to quarantine these precious little children for a year.
We didn't see Santa. We have not been to restaurants or the mall. We go on walks. Luckily, we've had a really mild winter.
A few family members have visited. A photographer comes to the house for their milestone portraits. Now they're waiting for spring, waiting for the end of cold and flu season, waiting to see if after months of coping with constant crisis, they can learn to live with normal.
Hopefully June, we'll say, okay, a year and a half later, come on over and meet them.
When Reed looks at me laughing now and jumping in my lap, I can't help but think back to the days when I wasn't allowed to touch him.
I'll never ever take that for granted, just to be able to hold my baby at the end of the night.